Good morning, George.
So, given its positioning, any color you want as long as it's black, why is that on the Sport GT?
On the interior, well, I think a lot of the, you know, it's got a unique headliner, it's dark, you know, we can look at other options in the future, but typically the sportier cars have a darker interior, black interior, so just want to kind of position it that way. Similar to the launch of sedan Sport.
John?
Prices?
Not out yet, John.
Pricing.
Yeah. What will we have? Anything?
Soon.
Yeah.
Close. You know, within a week or two.
Yeah. Christy?
Well, as far as like within two drivetrains, about 15% of the turbo, so 85% of the 2 liter. Overall, Elantra GT has been averaging about 10% overall percent of sales of Elantra.
So there's no real production limitation with this product, so it's it will sell at its natural sales pace.
Yep. So, question on the 16-manual DCT, 16-manual Sport, GT Sport. You can't get the tech package on that, or are you able to?
No, the tech package is only with the DCT, and part of that is because of the advanced driver assists, whether it be, you know, the auto cruise control, the automatic emergency braking. That's DCT only at this point, but always looking to change that.
Anyone else? Joe.
On sale date, Chris, and where is it built?
So, it's they're just beginning to arrive now, so it's fair to say that there'll be inventory in our retail outlets probably by the second week of August. We should have availability nationwide.
It was
still
made in Korea?
Yes, it's made in Korea.
True.
I can get that for you. Just released.
Okay. Christy?
Sportier, we've got a Elantra Sport.
I mean, you know, Elantra Sport, it lines up pretty well with SI, I think. So we've got the sedan SI at 201 horsepower. Now we have the 5-door variant. So there is some, you know, variation or differentiation between the two. So I think it lines up pretty well with SI. Yes.
From
the market, obviously, is saying we like crossovers. We like the crossover idea. Do you think that customers who are shopping for a car will come into a dealership and look at this and perceive it, no matter what you call it? Mm-hmm. Will they perceive this as a crossover-like vehicle?
I mean, I think it's a perfect alternative to a crossover. You saw, you know, cargo capacity is larger than a lot of the entry or smaller CUVs. Age point, how you sit in the car, as I realize some people like to sit higher, but some people like to sit lower and have more fun to drive capability. So I think it can be perceived and is a viable option to CUVs.
I think that's a good idea, but also keep in mind too, this interior is completely different than our Elantra sedan.
Yeah.
And it has a very European flavor, it has a tablet style display compared to the conventional display you find in most sedan products that we have in Elantra sedan. And so there'll be a number of customers that look at this product, and it just has the appearance of being much more upscale and European compared to the sedan side interior. So we'll bring customers from that side as well, I think.
To your point, it seems to me that what has become passé somewhat in the market is the three-box idea, right? Mm-hmm. The sort of the front, the middle, the back. This is, from a fashion standpoint, is what's out right now. And this would be, seem to me, means what's kind of a one-box.
And the segment is growing. I mean, based on what I've seen forecast-wise, 21% increase. I know there's new entrants and Cruise and Civic. But yeah, the segment is growing. Whereas, you know, compact in general is maintaining, let's say. But the compact hatchback definitely is growing. And then to your fuel economy question, sorry, to your gears. The 2-liter automatic combined, 26. And 1.6 turbo or GT Sport DCT combined is 28.
Is that the only number you have, Mike? Do you have city highway?
I have all, yeah. I'll offline, I can give you everything.
Okay. All right, couple thoughts. Go ahead, Gary.
So, we have time. Of your, we have an I-30 parked outside next to one of these. How much?
It's very similar. Obviously, we do our suspension tuning here in North America to our tastes, so there is a little variation on that. But for the most part, interior, exterior, almost identical. I think we get better powertrains here. I think there's there is a diesel in Europe, but they have the 1.4 turbo, where we have the 1.6 turbo. They don't offer the 2-liter GDI. So in general, I think our powertrains are slightly more powerful, but other than that, it's pretty close to what you get over there.
What are our tastes for suspension compared to your
difference in road characteristics, freeways, freeway hop, all that kind of thing? Just a little bit different what you have to deal with here. You can't take one tune and apply it globally. That doesn't work.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Thank you. A couple things. We've got 18 vehicles. We get a lot more of you than